Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to another video and welcome to my channel if you're new here. In today's video, I'm going to be talking to you guys on how to use Western Union. Now, this is a service that is extremely important, especially if you work at Publix. So a little bit of background knowledge about me, if you don't know me and you're new here, is I am currently a pharmacy technician at Publix. I just switched over to that department because I was previously a customer service associate for about 3 years in the same company. I absolutely love Publix and dedicate a lot of my time and videos into showing you guys and give you guys tips and advice on how to enhance and excel in the company. Now, Publix has not paid me, sponsored me, none of that. So all of my opinions or tips and tricks and stuff like that are truly based on my own knowledge, my own experience, and me wanting the best for you guys. None of it is forced. None of it is for money. None of it is anything with, you know, an ulterior motive other than me to help you guys. So if you guys want to get a bag, enhance your money, learn how to do well in a company, because a lot of my tips can be for multiple companies, not just Publix, or multiple jobs. Sometimes people work in medical offices, sometimes people work in restaurants with food and clubs, just a whole bunch of different jobs, and I kind of like cover it all in this channel. So if you guys could please like, comment, and subscribe, I would truly appreciate it because we're on a road to 5K. Now, in today's specific video, like I said, I'm going to be covering Western Union. Now, you can be a Western Union employee and not specifically work at Publix, so this is still going to be beneficial for you. But like I said, my specific video and what I'm talking to you guys about today is based on the experience I have from Publix. Now, let's go ahead and get right into it. Western Union is one of the most common things that you're going to find as a customer service associate. As a customer service associate, don't be so worried about bringing people up or doing the basic things that cashiers do, because that's why the cashiers are there. When you go to a customer service associate, yes, you're supposed to know how to ring people up. Yes, you're supposed to know how to deal with coupons and stuff like that. But that's kind of like what the cashiers are there for. People are going to the customer service counter really when they need Western Union, lottery, cigarettes, things that they can't find from their cashiers or baggers. So you have to know what you're doing if you want to be able to perform well in the task you're given. And I'm gonna try my best to explain it to you guys because it is a little hard without a computer or without specific paper, and I'm technically not allowed to share that information even if I did have access to it. But I'm gonna try to speak on what I know, and when you guys see the paper or the computer screen, you're going to remember me, you're gonna remember my voice, and you're gonna know what it is that you're doing. So Western Union, like I said, is on the computer, okay? Publix is going to give you, or anywhere you work at, obviously like a code, a login, stuff like that. And a lot of times it is abbreviated to WUPOS, okay? WUPOS is what they call it, okay? I know it sounds kind of funny, but that's what they call it, WUPOS. So once you log into the computer, you're gonna go ahead and select the WUPOS option, which is like this little, it's gonna be like in the little square, like kind of like an app, like you're opening an application, right? So the WUPOS page is going to open. Now everything is pretty, I feel like, self-explanatory, but I know at first it's just overwhelming, and that's what tricks a lot of people. So on the side option, there's going to be different tabs. The first one is usually send money. The second one is receive money. The third one is transfer money, like to send it to like prison, like to make a payment, stuff like that. So honestly, guys, if you don't know what WUPOS is, let's just start from there, because then you're not going to really understand everything else I'm saying. So Western Union is a money service transaction where people can send, receive, or make payments through this kind of like application, through this process. And you're basically the person who is guiding them, you're receiving the money, you're charging them, you're basically the one who's helping them to make that transaction. Okay, so that's why you're considered a Western Union agent. So when you're at Publix and you are a customer service associate, you technically have to know how to do this Western Union thing. So when people ask you, what do you do? Not only are you a customer service associate, you're a Western Union agent, and that's how it is. Now, if you leave Publix, technically you're not certified for Western Union, so you're not a Western Union agent if you leave Publix, but you are while you work in the company. So I mean, hey, you know, more things to say about yourself, right? Now, when you when you go ahead and click on the application, right, and it opens up and you see the options to send money, receive money, or make a payment, you're just going to go ahead and ask the customer. The customer is going to tell you, I want to send money. This is the most common one. A lot of times people want to send money. Now, sending money means that Ralph from Florida wants to send money to his son in Texas, okay? He wants to send $200, he wants to send $300, he wants to send the boy $400 so that he can buy himself a nice present and he can pay for his car payment. That's what sending money is. Receiving money is when his son in Texas, you know, Ralph's son's in Texas, sends Ralph $200, so Ralph came to Western Union to pick up his money. And making a payment is not the same thing as sending money. So listen to this one, because a lot of times people get confused. Making a payment is when you got to pay like a company or a place. So for example, this is the most common one you're going to find, or this is the one I found most common in the 3 years that I did Western Union, and me and my coworkers all said the same thing. Making a payment, a lot of times people would come up to the customer service associate desk and be like, oh, I need to send money to my nephew who's in jail. Okay, and this is not like to make fun of anyone. This is not a funny matter. This is what it is. If you don't understand the system, like when someone goes to jail or something like that, you might not truly understand. But obviously, like these inmates and stuff, they need money so they can buy themselves their food or stuff like that. It's just like a whole different system inside the jail. So anyone who's willing to help you outside of the jail has to send money into like your cell, like the, what is it called? It was at the tip of my tongue and I forgot. Whatever, they have to send money to basically like your unit, let's say. So I know it can get tricky because a lot of times the customers, they don't know how the system works. So they just come up to this counter and they're just like, oh, I need to send money to my nephew who's in jail or something like that. And usually they're not gonna say the jail part. They're just gonna say, I need to send money to my nephew. But the way Western Union sees this is that you're not sending the money directly to your nephew or to your niece or whoever it is that's in jail, because they're in jail. So they're physically not receiving like, I guess, the money like that, but you're sending it to the prison, and the prison is the one that's kind of like giving it to the inmates. So that would be considered making a payment, okay? So that's a really, really big one, because a lot of times when people need to make a payment, that's what they're coming there for, or FPL, Florida Power and Light. So a lot of times, you know, if people need to make a payment for their house, they're gonna say, oh, I need to send money to FPL. They're not really like sending money to FPL. They're making a payment for FPL. So you, as the customer service associate, you need to be able to differ. Like, okay, FPL, yeah, that's more of like a business. That's not a specific person. So that's a making a payment, not sending money. Now, if by any chance you click the sending money button and then all of a sudden you realize midway, you know, when you're talking to the customer's like, yeah, he's, you know, in this specific jail, in this county, whatever, you're gonna realize, oh shoot, it's not sending money, it's making a transfer. Or making a payment, I'm sorry. So you're just gonna go ahead and tell the customer, oh, I thought it was sending money. That's, you know, if he's in jail, that's really making a transfer. So let me cancel this. And you're just gonna go ahead and put the information into the making the payment option. And it's fine. You know, you're not gonna be flagged for it as long as you don't actually like send the money, which by the way, the system probably won't even let you send if the information isn't accurate, which it won't be if this person is like, you know, not really a person, if it's a company, stuff like that. But just let you guys know, it's okay to start something and then, oh, you know, you realize midway and you gotta switch. Try for it not to happen, but it's okay as long as the money isn't like physically sent or anything. Other common things you're gonna see for making payments are just things basically like I said about the house or a business. So if someone needs to pay their house rent or someone needs to, you know, pay something in their business, in a company, stuff like that, that all comes under making a payment because that's not physically a person. Sending money is person to person. Sending money is I'm Patricia Isabel, and I'm sending money to you, Stephanie Rodriguez. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what sending money is. Making a transfer is me sending money to my uncle in jail because he needs his lunch money or something like that. Now, another important thing to know is all these transactions have to be under $3,000, because if not, you have to fill out an EMST form, which I will do a separate video on. And in the meantime, if someone does try to do a transaction more than $3,000, make sure you go ahead and ask a manager, because the process is completely different. Just know though, if it's under $3,000, it's okay for you to go ahead and go through with the transaction. If it's over, they can still send that money, but you're gonna need more identification. It's gonna be a longer process and things like that, which like I said, I'll explain, but ask a manager, because you can't process that without having filled out certain forms and stuff like that. Next thing that I wanna address is, I just wanna throw in this little side note. Money orders are completely different than Western Union, and that's another thing you gotta keep your eye out for, because a lot of times people say, oh, I need to send money, or I need to make a payment, and what they're really implying is money order. I know it's not on you, it's really on them, but you gotta try your best to really understand and get a feel for the situation, because you're the one kind of like servicing them, and they don't know, they're not educated, so I mean, can you really blame them? So I'm gonna do a separate video on money orders, but that's the fourth kind of money service that Publix offers. So the first three is Western Union, sending money, receiving money, and making a payment. And then there's the money orders, which I'll do separately. That's definitely something that you want to keep in the back of your head, okay? Now, when someone says send money, they physically just want to send money to their niece or nephew or their uncle or just anyone, okay? Sending money is practically, I feel like, one of the easier ones. Because everything is so standard. So you're gonna go ahead and click the sending money option, and it's going to ask you to type in the phone number of the person who's sending the money. So you're just gonna go ahead and ask the customer, like, hey man, you know, what's the number? And they're gonna tell you, my number is 305-1018, whatever. You type in the number. You're gonna go ahead and click search. You're gonna ask the customer for their name. Make sure you ask open-ended questions. Don't just be like, oh, you are, like, ask them to make sure, because sometimes people try to be sneaky and they be trying to like pass themselves as people who they're not, and you can get flagged for that too, for allowing it to happen. You know, I know it's out of our control sometimes, but just keep your eye on stuff like that. So after you ask them for their name, okay, you're gonna go ahead and select the option of, you know, their name or their new sender, okay? If they've never sent through Western Union before, you have to go ahead and make a profile for them. Everything is self-explanatory. Whatever the system asks for you to write, you're gonna ask the customer and you're gonna fill in the blanks. Then the system is going to ask you to who is your customer sending the money to. So you're gonna ask the customer, to who is it that you're sending the money to? They're gonna tell you, oh, I'm sending it to Max in Texas. So you're just gonna go ahead and write that the person is sending it to Max in Texas. You're just gonna fill in the blanks, okay? Sometimes the people are already in the system and all you gotta do is select the name. Sometimes they're new and you have to type in their full name. So usually what I do is I print out a little bit of the receipt paper or give them like a sticky note or something like that, and I have the customer write out the name for me, because if the person's name is spelled Max with two X's and I only put one X, Max with two X's from Texas will not be receiving the money that his dad or whatever is sending him. So you gotta be very careful. So just to play it safe, have the customer write out or tell you out loud how to spell the name, because you wanna avoid as many mistakes as possible. Now, once you do that, the system's gonna ask you for how much. So you ask your customer, how much do you want to send Max from Texas? The customer might say, I want to send him $5. The person might say, I want to send him $200. Whatever they say is what you write, okay? And then the system is going to calculate the shipping fee, which is what you're going to tell the customer. Then you're going to print a pre-disclosure, okay? You select the print option, and in the pre-disclosure, your customer service associate is going to tell you what you want to highlight. But basically, this is kind of like the pre-approval before you send something. So you're gonna present it to the customer and be like, hey man, does everything look correct, okay? And if the customer says yes, then they need to go ahead and sign that piece of paper, because that way, if you make a mistake, you cover yourself by being like, look, I printed out the pre-disclosure with all the information he told me. He signed off of it, meaning that it was correct, so I sent it, and then he changed his mind. So that's kind of like what covers your butt, okay? So make sure you guys, you know, I know sometimes these customers get aggy, like, oh, I gotta sign two papers and stuff like that. Yeah, you do, because those are the rules. And that's how it is in the handbook. So I know not all customer service associates do this, but I promise you, anytime they've gotten into some type of problem or disagreement or something with a customer, or they've sent the wrong amount or to the wrong place or something, they have wished that they would have followed those rules that would have covered them. Because technically then they're not covered and they get written up for that. And there's nothing you can do because you didn't follow the directions. So it's something so simple, so why break it, you know? So after the customer signs that pre-disclosure, then you're just gonna go ahead and select the option that the customer assigned the pre-disclosure agreement, and you're gonna proceed to the next step. The next step is to fully send the money. So at that point, you're gonna charge them on the cash register. Once they finish paying, then you can send the money. Don't send any type of money before they pay, okay? Because then what if they don't wanna pay or they change their mind and you already sent that money? So now you're $200, $300 short or whatever, because that customer isn't paying you that, but you already sent that. Because Western Union and Publix is two different things. That's a service that we offer, but we don't function with the money that's being sent, okay? So make sure you receive that payment before you press send. And after that, that's basically how you do it. It's super simple. Now, I can tell this video is getting a little bit long because it is a lot of steps that you have to take being a Western Union agent. So I'm gonna go ahead and split these videos into three parts. Part one was today's, which was how to send money through Western Union. Tomorrow's part is going to be part two, which is how to receive money through Western Union, and then how to make a payment through Western Union will be part three. So I hope you guys stay in tune because these are all really, really important, especially as a customer service associate. And I would have made it all in one video, but I know as someone young and someone who has things to do also, you guys are probably busy and don't want to watch a 40-minute long video. So I think it's just easier if I split it into parts, but I hope this video helped you guys on how to send money through Western Union. And if you guys have any kinds of questions, make sure you ask me. Make sure you also ask a manager, guys. A lot of times, I love you guys' questions. All the time, I love you guys' questions. But a lot of times, people ask me instead of asking their managers, which is perfectly fine. But know that these managers are getting paid to do something. They're not getting paid to sit in their office all day. So a lot of times, I've dealt the same problem with my managers. And like some of my coworkers are like, oh, I don't want to ask them because they're busy in their office and stuff like that. And I'm like, babes, that's what they're getting paid to do. Okay. Me over here, I'm not getting paid to do this. I'm doing it because I want to help y'all. And I'm not even a manager. So make sure you don't feel intimidated or anything, because it's going to be worse if you make an error. Ask them. They're there to help you. And so am I. So make sure you comment down below, because that's the quickest way to reach me. But other than that, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Literally, part two. Let's get it. Bye.